get activated. Let's get activated. Let's get activated. Creepy in the pocket, let it go. Them bullets penetrate. When you in that field, it get real. Just stay dedicated. Go.
Put me in the game, I know what to do. That's another set, cause I be running through it. I set up the play, I'ma make a move. It's gonna be a blitz if I run into you.
NFL is on EA Sports, and we are at Raymond James Stadium in Tampa, Florida. With the echoes of cannon blast still ringing in our ears from the north end zone, the Bucs were introduced a moment ago, and they are all set as their guys will do battle with the Atlanta Falcons. To go, Young Wei Koo ready to do the honors. And off we go from Tampa. And boy, a rough start to this one as this kick goes out of bounds. Taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Brady now on first down. He'll check this one off to Fournette. And he'll go down inside the 45 before going out of bounds. 3 yards the gain there, second down. Giovanni Bernard. 3 yards is half of what they needed. Now can they get the other three here on third down? Now Brady. He's got it complete to Gronkowski. And he's going to get this down near the 30-yard line.
We often hear the phrase sure-handed tight ends, and he certainly fits into that category. Plus, he's got a quarterback who knows to look his way when they need a big pickup. And on this play, he finds it for the first down.
So first and 10 now from the 30. goes right side. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. Giovanni Bernard, 30 yards. And the Bucs have taken a first quarter lead.
Throughout the game, we're going to track so many different statistics, but one is becoming increasingly in vogue. Explosive runs of 20 yards or more, and we just saw one right there to open this game.
Now we'll see how the other team responds, because when you get a play like that against you this early in the game, you gotta feel like your back's against the wall a little bit.
Yeah, the pressure now increases on you because your first thought is we have to answer right now.
Extra point up and good by Succa, and that makes the score 7-0. Following the touchdown now, it's Bradley Pinion on to kick this one away. Fielded just outside the goal line. Oh, a good return up past the 30. And a good return, able to get out across the 35 to the 36. Good starting field position for them here as they come up first and 10 at their 36-yard line. And oh, right away, he lost the football. But this will fortunately wind up out of bounds. They're already trailing here in this first quarter. Last thing they needed was to cough the football. Well, they coughed it up, but luckily for them, it went out of bounds.
Yeah, still a long way to go, but when you're losing, every possession takes on a little bit more importance, doesn't it? And in that case, they almost made this game a lot more difficult for themselves by turning it over. Fortunate there.
On second down now. It's Patterson, and nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. They'll say no gain on the play there. Now it'll be third down. Now Ryan. That's complete to Sharp, and able to rip off a big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40.
I think it all came together there. In breaking route, drove it with excellent pace. Money throw right there to move the sticks.
Now Ryan on first down. And that throw behind his man. He missed him. Incomplete.
It certainly didn't appear that that's where he wanted to go with the ball initially, so he tried to get something out of it by dumping it off to his running back unsuccessfully.
Throwing again on second and 10. Ryan, and that'll be incomplete.
I think we'll see more of them trying to get him the football out of the backfield. They love what he can do in open space, and they believe that he creates mismatches they can exploit.
Ryan. Toward the sideline. Did he keep the feet in? Yes, he got them both down, says the side judge, and that's good enough for a first down. Nice job keeping that opening drive alive, and they're in plus territory, that part of the field where you really want to convert on third down. They did.
Big time pickup for them, and now I think the aggressive play callers think to themselves, this part of the field, I take my shot at the end zone, because the closer you get to the end zone, the field gets condensed. Makes it a lot tougher to run those people right now. Take your shot at the end zone early in the down and distance count.
They'll get him to the ground at the 20 following a pickup of four.
Brandon, you know this is going to be discussed because this is the fear of all the backs when they run this type of a route. They've got to find the football, and sometimes they don't see the defender. And in this case, he took a pretty good shot for his efforts, but give him credit, able to hold on to the football. That was well played, but that was also an example of a corner who understands his coverage, realized he had support behind him, and could be a little more aggressive in the shorter zone, and did exactly that, knocking that pass away.
They'll try and throw for it with Ryan. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. The Falcons go for it, but it doesn't work out. And the Buccaneers defense holds, and they get the football back. Bucks offense set to begin their next possession. Now they'll be looking to duplicate the efforts of drive number one that resulted in 7 points in the 7-zip lead.
Well, you know how much I enjoy horse racing, right? Looks like they caught a flyer out of the gate, as they would say when you're running the big-time races. It means they get out to a fast start. They're setting the pace, making the other team chase now.
After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. Second and nine now from the 21. Throwing now is Brady. And that is incomplete.
I'm looking at this with my defensive eyeglasses on, because you remember the old days when a tight end saw a linebacker covering him and thought he had a mismatch? But the way they can run nowadays, not necessarily so. They gave it a shot downfield. That one incomplete.
After an incomplete pass on second down, that'll leave him trying to convert on third and nine. That's complete to Tyler Johnson. And he is going to have the Buccaneers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Here's Bernard. And he will lose yardage here to the 31-yard line. So a loss of five, and it'll be second down.
How about the job there on the outside? Shed the wide receiver and was able to make the tackle on the perimeter.
So a five-yard run the other way in the wrong direction, and that leads us to second and 15. Shotgun now for Brady. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield.
Hey, partner, they're locked in man coverage out left, and they end up running a crossing route. Rounded it a little bit more than a slant. He's just going to angle himself towards the right side of the field, and that's very difficult for a defender to shadow him across all that ground.
And a six-yard gain gets him right around the 43.
That play wasn't quite as big as the play that preceded it, but still, got to like the way they're moving the football, partner.
Absolutely. Pretty good room to run on that last play.
Yeah, they didn't get a first down, but still, you'll take runs like that each and every time, won't you?
Second down at four. They give him about four on the play, but he's marked short, so it'll be third and about the length of the football. To throw is Brady. This is caught by Evans. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. Mike Evans, 39 yards, and the Bucs are going to add on to their lead.
I know these wide receivers are about flash and dash and high-flying plays, but a good number of them played running back at some point in their career, and that's how they finish off a lot of their big plays, run after the catch.
And this time he finishes off the big play in the end zone. Extra point put through by Succum, and it's now 14-0. Now Pinion with the kickoff honors following the touchdown. And that one bounces out of the back of the end zone, so we'll start the drive at the 25 on the touchback. Set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. And on the last drive, they were in field goal range. They just opted not to kick it, didn't get it. How does that change the mentality this go around?
I don't think it changes much for the head coach, because this is what he preaches all the time. Attack at all times in any spot on the field. And he likes touchdowns, not field goals. Now, your field goal kicker, you got to make sure you nurse him through and say, okay, don't worry about it. When we need you, you've got to be ready to go. And the team, of course, loves to see points on the board. So let's see if it changes a little bit if they're in the same spot again.
Yeah, we'll see what the decision is here if they get to that spot. I got room for this, man. 2 minutes to play, first half. It's 14 to nothing. A reminder, coming up at halftime, Jonathan Coachman will join us from Orlando with our halftime report, but business to take care of before we get there.
A two-minute drill before the coach's two-minute drill.
Looking to throw again on second down. Ryan, he will find Ridley. That's complete. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Throwing now, Ryan on first down. Throw out right, taken in by Patterson. And he'll lose yardage here, back at the 41. He was unable to shake free there. They'll cover him for a loss of a yard. Second and 11 at the 41. They go play action now. Ryan. And he gets this one to Ridley complete. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. To throw is Ryan. Airing it out, looking for Ridley. And he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete.
I believe I'm following their logic. Take the big shot downfield, loosen things up. You're hoping to get some points on the board before the half. Maybe now you come back and throw some underneath stuff in order to make sure you get a completion.
To throw again is Ryan. Open man is Kyle Pitts, his tight end. And this is going to lead to another first down as the tackle's made at the Bucs' 13-yard line. Now the Falcons going to use one of their timeouts as the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half.
From the 13 now, they work on first and 10.
From the red zone, Haken in by Ridley for a Falcon touchdown. Calvin Ridley there to make the grab.
And the Falcons are on the board here in the final minute of the first half.
The way this one was going, you just got the sense they needed something before half. They've at least got something on the board now. Still trailing, but a good sign.
That takes me back to our preseason tour of NFL camps. You remember we talked with that one coach who said his emphasis this year was scoring in the last 2 minutes of a half, heading into the locker room. This hits it right there. Take that momentum, take that good feeling, and take it to the locker room, regroup, and start over. They got it here.
They did indeed, and a lot of football, full half to be played.
Following the touchdown, here's Koo to kick off.
It's a squib kick fielded just inside the 20. And he'll be stopped up at the 25.
The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started. And with a little under a minute to go, still time to try to put a drive together to add to their lead should they so choose.
The drive starts with a handoff to Bernard. And up to the 35 before they're able to knock him down. 43 yards rushing for him now, and he's carried the ball just five times.
Well, as we've learned over the years, just because a guy plays left tackle doesn't mean he doesn't have run-blocking abilities, and we just saw it there. Controlled the line of scrimmage, created a big gain.
that's kind of a bonus. He's there to protect that high value that you have back under center, but he creates space in the run game.
Yeah, not only can he dance, he can mash too.
Now a carry for Bernard. Yeah, this is going to be a Bucs first down as he's got this up to the 45-yard line. That's it for the first half. Two more.